forget playing the piano and just focus on the things that I tell you.
I have her listen to the piece of music that she'll have to play, and I'm teaching Ishani using 6 or 7 different levels of unconscious learning.
So the music becomes something that you feel inside your limbs, inside your head, along your eyes.
We continue to monitor Ishani to ensure she's doing the exercises I set her. 1 week from now, she'll have to play at Wigmore Hall, the famous chamber music venue.
I'm really looking forward to it, but the kind of thinking part of me would really like to know what's going on. There seems to be something missing. After the sessions with Derren, I don't really remember that much. I don't really think about it. I really haven't discussed it with my friends. I suppose they're slightly concerned that I'm spending hours with a crazy mind control guy and I don't remember what's happening.
Ishani has returned for her final session with me. In 3 days' time, she will have to play a piece of music at Wigmore Hall.
So each line and each space corresponds to a note on the keyboard, all right? And forgive me if you...
I start with a rudimentary introduction as to how the notes on the manuscript paper relate to the keys on a piano.
E, you take a mental photograph of each page.
Throughout the session, I continue to use a variety of subliminal techniques to develop her skills.
It's just about forgetting everything, forgetting playing the piano, and just allowing yourself, just focusing on that area around your finger, storing and archiving. Imagine yourself on stage with the advantages of a slowed down sense of time. So your own internal process is working so much quicker than the outside.
If you can believe that it's hopeless and that you haven't got a clue how to play a note, you can believe that if you like, or you can make a choice to allow yourself to the music that you're creating.
More of Ishani later. We go to Gallagher's Steakhouse in New York. It was one of the first Prohibition-era speakeasies for the gamblers and stars of Broadway. Tonight, diners have been told that there is a camera crew documenting the abilities of one of the waiters who claims to be psychic and handsome.
Hi there, how are you guys doing? Can you just order?
Yeah.
Okay, don't tell me what you want, I'm going to try and do that for you.
Oh.
All right?
Okay.
So, first of all, I'm going to put you both down, I think, for the same starter. And I think that's going to be the soup. Yeah?
Yeah.
The main course, I think you're going to go for a lighter option. I don't think there's actually vegetarian there, but I'd put you down, I think, for the salmon.
Yes.
I'll put you down for the steak. Yeah, of which there's more than one. We'll go for the...
Gotta do better than that.
Hanger steak?
You got it.
How'd you like that, medium rare?
You got it.
Desserts, again, lighter for you. So cheesecake for you. And so either I'm going for the custard or the sorbet. I'm going to go for the custard for you, am I right?
Yeah.
Excellent. Good. Well, thank you. Well, if you don't mind, I'll take this a little bit further. I think you both see yourselves as highly dynamic and charged people, and people that seem to sort of circle the world in a different orbit from the rest of us, and they tend to make otherworldly connections with each other. So I'd imagine one of the things that brought you together would be the fact that you'd be the same star sign. Is that correct? Yeah? Now, it's bullshit, and I don't believe in that, but Pisces, Aries? Aries, Pisces, one of the two? Yeah, Aries, great, okay. Think of something I really couldn't know. Do you have a pet?
Used to.
Used to, okay. What type of pet?
A dog.
A dog, okay. Can you remember his name?
Yeah.
Or her name? Great, okay, just say the name for yourself. In fact, just pick a letter somewhere in the middle of the name. All right, I'll just try it with a letter somewhere in the middle of the name. You just look at me and think it's an L?
Yeah.
Yeah, great, okay. Just say it yourself. This is a dog you used to have. Died a few years ago?
No.
No, you've given him to somebody else?
Yes.
Okay, all right. Roly, Riley. Riley? Again?
Riley.
Riley, okay. Excellent. And is James proud of you?
Yeah.
Yeah, your father?
Yeah.
You see, what you've learned from him, you've learned a real, a kind of a dislike of authority, a dislike of being told kind of what to do, constantly trying to, trouble paying your car, speeding fines, speeding tickets.
It was like a parking ticket.
Did you get into trouble for it?
No.
I can see you're not paying parking tickets and getting into trouble for that. When you were young, you did something with your sister. You cut or damaged or something your sister. Was it with the razor?
Yes.
Good, you should call your sister more often. Elizabeth?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
You should call her. She'll visit more often if you talk to her more. Enjoy your meal. I'll go get you food.
Thank you.
Oh,
the thing is, I didn't pay a ticket. and I lost my license. I don't know if he meant that.
It's the morning of the piano recital, and my first session with Ashani was only just over a week ago. She still isn't sure whether she chose a trick or a treat.
Can you play the piano?
Basic.
You are going to be giving a concert, a piano recital. But that is the last time you're going to play the piano between now and then.
Do you know what card you picked?
Do I know what card I picked? I think I picked treat. I think it feels like a treat so far. If I don't completely go with it, then I know there's even less chance that it's going to work. No, it will be fine. It has to be.
Okay, we're just going to come down and have a quick look at the set. You look amazing.
Thank you.
How are you feeling at the moment?
All right, a bit shaky.
Okay, yeah, you seem a bit less confident than...
Yeah, it's kind of deteriorated slightly since I last saw you, I think.
Okay, let's go down and have a look at the stage. This is a piano. Have a seat. Let's get comfy. No playing. So, just so you know, just to give you a starting point, the first notes of the piece are this C here and this C here. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now we need to let the audience in because people are already here. They're sort of mingling around in the foyer.
Okay. It just seems insane. Everybody. I think either me or Derren or both of us are insane.
Ashani is one of three pianists performing today, and we've made sure she goes on first in the concert.
How are you doing?
Not great.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We'll just take some time to relax for a bit. A healthy lunchtime.
I think I can do it.
Pardon?
I just don't want to do it. Genuinely.
That nervousness, that adrenaline will, you know, it will aid your performance. Be fine. Just trust it. Sit down. Start playing. It'll all come.
This is a sophisticated lunchtime audience who regularly attend recitals and are used to a very high standard of playing.